Hello everyone! This tutorial is for all of you who have been searching for the Start tab in VT Pro. Yes, it is gone. But for good reason. We have massively extended the functions and everything that could be triggered upon start of a certain media, which is why this function had to be moved. So this tutorial will show you what's changed, where you can find that function now, and how it has grown and improved to let you do so much more than just show hide components like buttons and stickers. Let's go step by step. You may remember that there was a start subtab which let us define for each panorama in our list which elements it should show or hide. So we could have little stickers like this one, which are panorama specific, or we could show panorama specific hotspot highlights like this panel down here. And as you can see, when we switch to another panorama, these elements hide to make place for the new elements which are specific to this panorama. And the same also goes for other media. So say in this video, once we open it, you can see I defined that the previous elements that belong to the panorama hide, and we show a new element specific to this video, which is the X icon. So we're able to close the video at any point. All of this was previously defined in the Start subtab, which was located in the Panorama tab. So this is the old interface where we can still see the Start tab. And here in this list, we had one column for in, so when the panorama starts, and one for out upon leaving this panorama. So when we scroll down, we can see that we defined that sticker one should be shown upon entering this panorama, and it should hide or disappear when we leave it. So it won't show in whichever the subsequent media is that the user goes to. And the same for these other elements, which we just saw in the panorama. So again, that's the old system, which is a little bit tedious in terms of having to look for the elements in this long list, which is pre-tree mode. And it also limited us to just show hide elements, whereas maybe we wanted to trigger something else like activate hotspot X or play audio file Y. So you can guess, in the new version, we extended this function to include many, many more possible actions and things that you can define for certain media. Let's have a look. So indeed, the Start subtab has disappeared, leaving this area a little bit less overwhelming. But don't panic. The two functions that our Start subtab included have just moved places. So one was the initial view direction or start point, which you can now find in the zoom settings, set view as initial point. And the other function, so what to show on in and out of the panorama, is now right above under panorama actions, which also already indicates that this is now about more than just showing hiding elements and includes many kinds of actions that can be triggered upon the start of this panorama. So let's see how we would make a certain element show upon entering this panorama. We click Add Action and we select On Start. And then in this dropdown, as you can see, we now have a wide selection of possible actions that can happen when entering the panorama. Let's select Show Hide Components, and now we get our list of components pretty much like before, but better organized in the tree mode, so it's easier to find elements. And if we were using dual skins, we also have the option to select elements from the mobile skin. So this system is still similar to how it used to be, but it's definitely easier to find the element you're looking for thanks to the structured tree mode. In our case, for this panorama, at start we want to show sticker 1, and when we leave the panorama, that sticker 1 should hide. To make the whole show hide selection as easy as possible, we invented this new toggle button up here, which you can activate or deactivate. And what does that do? If it's active, what it does is it will automatically generate always the contrary action at out to what we select at in. Because this is what we usually want. To define visibility just for this one panorama and turn visibility off right as we leave it. So that's an easy way to save you some clicks. So we only click in the in column and it will automatically create the opposite in the out column so that we don't have to click that too and can save some valuable time here. So with the button activated, the out actions are generated automatically, But if we make the toggle button inactive, we can then work freely. We can work on each one independently. So you have both options and you just go and select the mode in which you feel more comfortable working in. All right, let me clean this up real quick. And finally, down here, we have something new as well, which is the effects section. So in here, when I select one of the cells up here, I can select an effect for it. Type, duration, animation type. Now, these are not new. We did have these effects before too. What's new, however, is the delay option, and that's super, super useful because it allows us to trigger the showing or hiding of elements with a time lag after the panorama opened or closed. So rather than having it always tied to the exact second in which the panorama opens and having everything happen simultaneously. These effects are always tied to the cell that I have selected up here, so I can do this for every cell individually and define different effects, durations, etc. for each component to have different elements appear at different times and maybe even with different effects. Or instead of having to go one by one, I can define these effects once and click apply to all. Then they'd all have the same specifications. Again, a big time saver. Okay, that's how we would get to the same result as before, but in the new system or layout. Plus, like I said, we now not only have the show hide action, but many more, including open panorama, open album, open floor plan, etc. Now, as we suggested at the beginning already, all of this is not only applicable to panoramas, but also to videos, to 360 videos, or even floor plans. So for all of this media, you have that same options to trigger whatever action upon starting that media. So in the video, for example, again, of course, our start tab is not up here, but we go to settings instead and find it all under video actions. And here we can see an example of how upon in, when the video starts, all skin elements should hide except for the X video. And when it finishes, they'll go to the contrary and all skin elements become visible again and the X video hides. The wide option of media actions that we added now gives us a crazy amount of things to play with. So we could take our video and make that at the beginning it appears paused. Or we could make that when it finishes, it'll open a specific album or a specific panorama so that we can essentially create a playlist of the media that is outside of the carousel, which is a predefined order of media. With this, we could say that once somebody opened this video, it'll then jump to this one and then to that one. And in between, we can open a panorama with absolute freedom and independent from the order we defined in the Publish tab. And as I said before, the same obviously goes for 360 video and floor plans. Lastly, a heads up, if you have old tours where you used the old start tab and checked the visibility of certain components at in and out, after this update, the software will recognize this and translate it into the new system, into the new actions, so that your tours will work perfectly. No need to worry about compatibility issues. Your tools will adapt automatically. And that's it. We hope you like this new addition. It may take a little bit for you to get used to the new location of the start settings, but we feel it is for the better as it allowed us to add many more auto-triggerable actions. And also architecturally, it made sense to change this because that's how the rest of the program works, based on adding actions to buttons, hotspots, components, etc. So that way it's the same logic and procedure. Thanks for watching.